We caught up with Sarah Palin at her home on the western end of Wasilla. The two-story home she and her husband built 5 years ago is ringed by evergreens and sawtoothed mountain peaks, and even has a parking spot for their seaplane out back.
I can't imagine you're going from governor of a small populated state, mm-hmm. sparsely populated, to all of a sudden you're being talked about for vice president, and you got this.
We got this. You know, Alaska seems to be such a microcosm of the rest of the U.S., and to me, it's the same people, the same issues here, much grander scale in some of the big cities that we're visiting, but everybody's got issues, everybody's got burdens.
But haven't you said to yourself at some point in the past 2 weeks, holy cow?
I haven't had time to think that yet or to say that. I have certainly said, wow, what an opportunity, and it's a humbling, humbling experience already. It's very humbling.
A little frightening?
Not so much frightening.
Overwhelming?
And not so much overwhelming, but just humbling. A great responsibility that I'm recognizing, a great responsibility. And certainly the drive to not let people down, not let women down in this.
You spoke.
That adds to it.
I saw you quoted somewhere as speaking rather admiringly of Mrs. Clinton, Senator mm-hmm. Clinton, mm-hmm. During the primary campaign. I think Obama should have picked her.
I think he's regretting not picking her now. I do. But what determination and grit and even grace through some tough shots that were fired her way, she handled those well.
We continued our interview in the comfort of the Palins' living room.
Governor John McCain and you are now talking about the GOP as a party of change. We've got a very sick economy. Tell me the three principal things you would do to change the Bush economic policies.
And you're right, our economy is weak right now, and we have got to strengthen it. And government can play an appropriate role in helping to strengthen the economy. We need to put government back on the side of the people and make sure that it is not government solely looked at for all the solutions, for one. Let me tell you what I did here in the city of Wasilla and then as governor of Alaska. What I did as a city council member then, and then as mayor, was come in and we cut personal property taxes in Wasilla. We cut small business inventory
taxes. And raised the sales tax.
Now, well, we had a 2% sales tax, and when people came to local government and said, we want a sports arena here, I said, that's fine, and I want a sports arena also, but we're going to have to pay for it.
Yeah, I didn't want to get off in Wasilla, but you came into the city with a debt-free city and left it with considerable millions of dollars of debt.
A $13 million sports arena that we bonded for, but see, we put government on the side of the people by asking them if that's what they wanted. It was a question on the ballot, and they got to vote yes or no, so that's what we did. We eliminated small business inventory taxes. I eliminated things like business license renewal fees on our small businesses. Those economic indicators of success on a local level should provide to America that worldview that I have of what we can do on a local level, and then a state level where we just suspended our fuel tax in our state also. Get taxes under control, but at the same time we're cutting taxes, you gotta reduce the growth of government.
But I want to come back to the question. I want to know, because you advertise yourselves now as the party of change, I want to know what you would change in the Bush economic principles. What you said to me at the beginning, I don't think anybody in the Bush administration would disagree with. What do you change in the Bush economic plans?
We have got to make sure that we reform the oversight also of the agencies, including the quasi-government agencies like Freddie and Fannie, those things that have created an atmosphere here in America where people are fearful of losing their homes, people are looking at job loss, people are looking at unaffordable health care for their families. We have got to reform the oversight of these agencies that have such control over Americans' pocketbooks.
So let me summarize the three things that you'd change in the Bush economic plans. One, two, three.
Reduce taxes. Control spending, reform the oversight and the overseeing agencies and committees to make sure that America's dollars and investments are protected.
So let me break down some of those down. You talk about spending. How much smaller would a McCain budget be Where would you cut?
We're going to find efficiencies in every department. We have got to. There's some things that I think should be off the table. Veterans programs, off the table. You know, we owe it to our veterans, and that's the greatest manifestation that we can show in terms of support for our military, those who are in public service fighting for America.
Take entitlements off the table? Or can we reform Social Security?
We need to get into every department, every division, and that's what's going to be the task of cabinet members, and then the next level of bureaucracy, and the next level of bureaucracy.
Well, I'm trying to get specific. You're saying you take military off the table. Do you talk about entitlement reform? Is there money you can save in Social Security, Medicare, Medicaid?
I am sure that there are efficiencies that are going to be found in all of these agencies. I'm confident in that.
But agencies are not involved in entitlements. Basically, discretionary spending is 18% of the budget.
We have certainly seen excess in agencies, though, and in when bureaucracy just gets kind of comfortable going with the status quo and not being challenged to find efficiencies and spend other people's money wisely. And maybe I'm wrong, but I believe that the American people, their will at this time is to see efficiencies reined in government so that the private sector and our families can grow and prosper.
The Interview, Sarah Palin with Charles Gibson.